Hey brothers and sisters, I hope you're doing well. It's a wonderful day to praise the Lord, isn't it? Man, sometimes I just think about the cross and I'm just robbed of description. And sometimes I'm just led to pray for a few people, which is why I'm here. I was actually on a long Facebook break and I was sensing in the spirit to pray for a few people, which is why I'm making this video. And I want to pray for you because you have been facing, some of y'all, I don't mean all of y'all, but some of y'all have been in this very tense juncture of their walk with God, especially in this season where, you know, you feel that, you know, it's like an exile situation, but this juncture where, you know, things might not be really sweet, it's bittersweet, but you're really trying to get a grasp on what's really going on. You know, to be very specific, I want to mention what God was telling me about. And I really pray. I want to pray for you. But before that, I want to exhort you. And these are the two kinds of people that God was telling me about. And which is why I'm here making this video to pray for you all. And I believe that God will reach you, bypass me, bypass the screen and reach right at you and heal that area of your heart. God was saying that there are a group of people who have this appearance of flourishing, this appearance that they're thriving, but then from inside they feel burnt out, they feel malnourished, they feel spiritually sapped, they feel sucked out, but outside they have a very good spiritual appearance. And then there is another group of people who are thinking or who are in the thought mindset that they are not doing enough for the kingdom of God, and by not doing enough they're paying a disservice to the kingdom of God. Now let me tell you, these two thought processes, they stem out of an identity crisis. They stem out of a pure spirit of orphanhood. I'm not condemning you, I'm just naming the problem. And let me tell you that these are a battle that a son and a daughter has to face before he or she goes to the next level. These are not things that, you know, that don't come. In fact, battles only come to those people when the day you said yes to Jesus, you had signed up indirectly for a few things which are not really welcoming, a few things which are not really pleasing, which are not really desirable, but yet they came. Why? Because the cost of following Christ was quite large, and at that time perhaps you just thought things would be hunky-dory. But the thing is that you deny everything, you deny yourself and follow him, right? So these are things that step in the way when the enemy wants to hijack your mind from being completely renewed, which is why these battles come. And it's a battlefield of the mind which needs to be conquered before you really understand your place and your reality and your glorious luxury and heritage in Christ, in the spirit. Man, I'm feeling it right in my bones when I say this. I want to tell you that we are created to comprehend with all the saints the height, the depth, the length of the love of God. We were created for this. We were created for this. And nothing in this whole wild world can separate you from this love of God. Which means that everything that the enemy has been communicating to you, that you're not doing enough, that you're not capable enough for this and that. Let me tell you, the word of God completely disregards that argument. You know why? Because you can't do anything in your strength in the word of God. In the kingdom of God, it completely switches narratives. You can't do anything with your strength in the kingdom of God. It's always in your weakness that his strength is perfected. Now let's come to the battlefield of the mind. The battlefield of the mind is only to talk you out of destiny. Because then there are some people who are not anchored in truth and not anchored in the presence of God, who can easily buy into the lie and start following that voice, and the enemy is going to sound like you, so you're going to feel as if it's your own thought. So I want to tell you today that it's a pure lie, and I'm communicating this to you because I've been through this. And in fact, anyone who lives godly, anyone who strives to live godly, who's following his word with fear and trembling, who's exercising salvation with fear and trembling, is going to go through this battle. You can take it. You know, the fathers of the faith that I've been seeing, and you know, the many patterns that I'm seeing of sons and daughters of God leaving a legacy, what I've seen is that when they start getting into the territory of the enemy to make that territory for the kingdom of God, to win those grounds for the kingdom of God, they will suffer these persecutions. But you are an overcomer. You are already one, which is why the word of God says, the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. It divides rightly between the soul and the spirit, joints and the marrows, is rightly discerning between the thoughts and the intentions of the heart. And every argument that rises itself up against the knowledge of God, we bring it to captivity to the obedience of Christ, right? So, I just want to encourage you with that. I really don't know what I spoke. I spoke whatever the Lord. So let's just pray. Father, I pray for this precious one watching. I thank you, Lord, that you have given us a spirit of freedom. Where your spirit is, there is liberty. Where your spirit is, there is joy, there is peace, there is hope. And Lord, I pray that this precious one would not lose sight in the face of all these stuff that's going crazy. Would not lose sight of what you've paid on that cross. May he or she never forget the destiny which is in front of them. And no matter how many lies it's surrounded with, that they will choose to believe in the truth, that they will resist the enemy and it shall flee. That they will win over these mind battles. They will win over all these battles that are completely talking them out. And I pray, Father Lord, that they would start growing in the richness of your spirit, that they would start realizing what is their place and their dignity and their heritage and their identity in Christ. No more orphan spirit. I completely cast out and rebuke the spirit of darkness, the spirit of orphanhood, the spirit of competition, the spirit of insecurity, the spirit of, oh, who's better, who's doing better spiritually. Lord, I pray, Father, for all these disturbing ripples of the mind to stop in the name of Jesus. May they be rooted and grounded in love, as your word says. I thank you and I speak shalom in their situation. Shalom. In Jesus' name I make this prayer. Amen. God bless you.